with another episode of Eagle Eye News.
Please rise for the pledge and remain standing for a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Pause for Change is hosting a donation drive for the Safe Harbor Humane Society. There's a wish list posted in your daily announcements email along with their Amazon wish list.
Donations will be sent out directly to the shelter. Donation boxes are located in the main entrance, activity entrance, and student services. Donations will be collected until February 18th.
Juniors, reminder that you'll be taking the SAT on April 13th here at Lakes. More information and prep classes can be found in your daily announcements email.
The Lakeville Library is hosting a summer job fair on Saturday, February 5th, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Registration and more information can also be found in your daily email announcements.
On Monday, February 14th, Lakes Women in Leadership Club is hosting Cupid's Crumble Cookies and will be selling cookies and custom cards.
The cookies will be $2 and the card and cookie package will be $4. The prepaid payments are due by February 7th to Ms. Reynolds.
Hey, Kat, do you see that stingray?
Are you talking about Mr. Giallo?
Yep, let's go check it out.
Hi everyone. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Mr. Giallo. I am a PE teacher here at Lakes Community High School. I'm also one of the varsity football coaches and an all-around good guy.
All right, so let's just get walking and started.
Hi, Hoff.
So, if you could describe yourself in hashtags, what hashtags would it be?
Hashtag rule follower, hashtag easygoing, hashtag teacher, hashtag sport lover.
Those are good.
Hashtag boy dad.
Boy dad.
I got three boys, so, and I'm a dad.
Yeah.
So.
What's one thing most people don't know about you?
One thing people don't know about me. One thing people don't know about me is that I spent a year in college at the University of Nevada, Las Vegas.
Mm-hmm.
So that's always, when people hear that, they're always kind of, oh, really? I never knew that. They're interested by that because I know Las Vegas is a place that people like to go on vacation, but no one really knows anyone who lives there.
Yeah. Was there like a certain major that you did?
I was a PE major. Technically, I was a kinesiology major because they didn't have physical education teachers mm-hmm. as a major there. But
that's interesting.
Yeah.
What's your favorite time of day?
My favorite time of day is the nighttime. I'm kind of a night owl. I like when things settle down a little bit. I can relax, watch a show, watch a Netflix show or a movie or something like that.
What shows have you been recently watching?
I watch Chicago Fire and Chicago PD on NBC, like they're really kind of cheesy shows, but I really just like the shots of the city and you know, kind of reminds me of when I lived in that area.
So you keep mentioning your kids. How old are your kids?
So my oldest son is 14 years old and he's an eighth grader. So he'll be at Lakes next year. And then my middle son is 12, he's a seventh grader, and my youngest is 9, and he's in fourth grade.
That's cool. What are three things you can't live without?
Three things I can't live without. Coffee. My family. And probably sports.
If you can have a superpower, what would it be?
Oh, so this is big. This is a big topic of conversation that happens in the PE office all the time.
Oh, okay.
So I think though, I'd want to be able to go invisible anytime, mm-hmm. right? So I can get around wherever I want to get around, maybe eavesdrop on some conversations, hear some people have to say about me.
Yeah.
I think I'd go invisibility.
That's interesting. If your life could be a song, what title would it have?
Oh, Gosh, that's such a good question. I don't know. I've never thought about it. I think, so this would be a stolen title.
Okay.
But I think I would take the title from the song Alive by Pearl Jam.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I want to be alive. I want to be in the moment. I want to enjoy everything. So.
What's the best thing that happened to you today?
The best thing that happened to me today was coming in this morning and getting to spend the first hour of my day with kids in the off-season lifting program for football. Those guys that show up every morning and have some dedication and commitment to want to get better every day, and getting to be around those guys that want to make themselves better.
Yeah. What's the worst thing that happened to you today?
I tripped over my son's baseball bag in my garage because our light doesn't work and it was dark when I left, and I ate it in my garage this morning. So that was the worst thing.
Glad you're okay though.
Yeah, thanks.
Glad you're okay. What's your favorite exercise since we're in the weight room?
Oh, weight room. Favorite exercise, hang clean.
Hang clean?
Yeah.
It's, can you demonstrate it for us?
Can I demonstrate the hang clean? You know, if you just sign up for my physical best class, those of you who haven't taken it yet, join it. I'll be more than willing in my physical best class to demonstrate the hang clean for you.
What's your favorite nickname?
I've had a lot through the years teaching in different places, but of late, some people like to call me Stingray. So I kind of, you know, I like that one. That's good. That's solid. I like to do the nickname thing, but Stingray for me. So.
Yeah. What time did you wake up this morning?
My alarm went off at 4:45 a.m.
That's early.
Yeah.
Well, that's all the questions I have, though. So it's a wrap for today, I guess.
Great. Thanks.
Thank you.
See you, Lakes Eagles.
Thanks, Mr. Giallo. Now let's throw it over to Cece and Sierra with sports.
Hey Eagles!
It's Sierra
and Cece,
and this is sports.
Congratulations, boys basketball, for beating North Chicago last Saturday.
Brock Marino had a double-double. He scored 21 points and set a new school record for the most rebounds in one game with 18.
Eli Roberts hit another game-winning buzzer against Braves Lake North, putting Lakes first in our conference.
Great job, boys.
Shout out to Cheer for getting fourth place at conference last weekend. Good luck at sectionals tomorrow.
Last Friday against Grant, Janae Pullen hit 8 threes in the fourth quarter and Jessica Oman hit one near the end.
Cece Fleming finished the job hitting a game-winning buzzer.
Girls Varsity Bowling placed second in the gold division in the Bulldog Invite. Ava Lewis won first place in the high three-game series with a series of 6-21.
Sienna Steinke placed third in high game award with a game of 244 and placed seventh overall individually with a total pinfall of 1,113.
Varsity Bowling also took second place in their meet at Island Lake.
Great job, ladies.
Congrats to Phil Hauser and Alec Malicio for qualifying for the IHSA Boys Bowling State Tournament.
Julia Blasinski scored a season-high vault with a 9.2 on senior night.
Good luck at regionals, ladies.
Now let's throw it over to
Kat and Matt.
That's all for this week, Eagles. If you have any suggestions or requests for EEN, please email lakesbroadcasting@chsd117.org.
Have a great weekend, Eagles.